road, honey.
Feel really good tonight. For those of you who don't know who I am, I'm Patti LaBelle. And I am from the South. Southwest Philadelphia, that is. Now, I'm not going to tell you how long it took me to get from there to here. You'll find that out tonight, okay? But there's some things that I'm not going to leave behind. Behind all the glitter and the glamour, all the sequence and the strutting, there's a really content lady under here. I have a home, a husband, and three children, and a wonderful family. And I just have to tell you one thing. When I found out I had my own television special, after I got up off the floor, honey, and called all of my friends, I took a fast tour of my closet because I love clothes. I love to wear everything. I just like to wear it all at once, but sometimes I can't. So I said, if I don't have it in my closet, I'll borrow it. And if I can't borrow it, I'll charge it. And since I only have one body, this is the only body God gave me, I said I would call some of my wonderful friends with some awesome bodies and faces and everything else to wear some of my drag. And they said, sure, we'll wear it. So since I couldn't wear it all tonight, I asked my friends to wear it. So this is the way I would have looked if I had the time. All right? Cyndi. Cyndi Lauper.
Thank you very much.
Oh, gosh. Oh, we're having fun tonight.
More fun than humans could possibly imagine.
I know they can't imagine this. Oh, this is fun. I'm going to sit down
three,
now.
Lying in my bed, I hear the clock tick and think of you. Caught up in circles, confusion is nothing new. Flashback, warm nights, almost left behind. Suitcase of memories.
Sometimes you picture me, I'm walking too far ahead. You're calling to me, I can't hear a word you said. Then you say,
the second,
and don't mind it.
The drum beats out of time.
If you're lost,
I'm
if you're
after time.
Right back with Bill Cosby and Amy Grant.
Patti LaBelle, Cyndi Lauper.
I said to the staff, I said, no matter how long it takes you, but when I leave this beauty salon, I don't care if Bruce Springsteen, Barbara Streisand, Prince, or Michael Jackson, if they're all out there passing out food stamps and $100 bills, I want the people to flock around me like ants at a picnic.
How about no moths what? To a flame?
That's good, too.
Yeah. But you see, you don't need all of this. I mean, you just have that kind of personality.
You don't think so?
Oh, are you kidding me? I mean, even as a little girl, I bet you people just flocked around you.
Oh, yes. That's what I was told by my mama.
Well,
she said they did. I don't know if it's true.
You knew because you were there. What are you blaming your mother for?
Well, you know how we girls are.
But you're a gorgeous person.
Don't stop. Keep going,
Listen,
Bill.
Listen, I can go Say on forever. Stuff. I'm telling you that when I hear you and you hit those notes... Uh-huh. I can close my eyes and you're the most beautiful. It didn't make any difference.
Well, close your eyes.
Now, see, you have this woman pampering you.
Yeah.
You get your nails done, toes
I love
done.
It. Yeah.
You're just lovely.
Outrageous.
See now, men, I'm just jealous.
I know you are. You guys don't have anything to do.
Nothing. We just
get that bad boy cut.
Please, just go and get a haircut. It's been like this ever since I was a kid.
Really?
Well, it wasn't boring.
Was it bad?
My first haircut was not boring.
But was it bad?
It was bad. I'm telling you.
Like scary?
Well, yeah, my father took me. Didn't make any difference.
Go ahead.
Yeah. So we went to the barbershop. He wore the bib overalls, always had his straw hat, kind of brown, you know.
Oh, really?
He was a very firm-looking man, hard-working.
I
went to the barbershop. I was so proud to go. I was so happy.
Were you
afraid?
It's
like I could see it. Well, then, you see, it wasn't that I was afraid. Far from it. Matter of fact, I wouldn't even let my father help me into the chair. I did it myself. Yes, indeed. Looked straight ahead and moved right into that chair. Zeppo.
Good for you, Bill.
The barber, I looked around at him. I liked him. Mm. He had no hair, you know. And I knew that was something that was important. As a man of thinking.
That's right.
So my father and the barber, they started to discuss how to cut my hair.
Mm-hmm.
Seemed to me they didn't know which end was up. See, my father saw the barber was having such a good time, he wanted to get into it, too. So he took me out of the chair, stood me in the sink.
In the sink?
Put the barber in my place, and made believe he was cutting the barber's hair.
Mm.
I laughed to make my father feel good, but it was obvious. See, I got my sense of humor from my mother's side of the family.
I bet. Go on.
See, I wanted to get a haircut so bad and get on with my date. But, see, my father had more jokes up his sleeve. See, he thought it would be hilarious if he got in the chair and got his hair cut before I did. So, once again, I laughed just to make him feel good.
Mm-hmm.
He was so grateful, he gave me a big hug.
Aww.
So, finally, I couldn't wait any longer. I figured if I wore my hat, no one would know whether I had a haircut or not. So, I just picked up my cap and headed for the door, left my father and the barber to figure out who gets the tip.
Oh, gosh.
Well, you can say that it was an event.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Well, can I treat you to a haircut, honey?
You are.
There's a famous line from a great play. It goes like this. I've always relied on the kindness of strangers. But I say, I've always relied on the kindness of friends. Friends are people who will always be there through thick and thin. They can be there for a day or for a lifetime. They can be of the flesh or of the spirit, in your heart or in your head. But a friend is someone who always loves with understanding, never taking, always giving. Always there supporting. And to live in a circle of joy like that is to live in a place where all things are possible, all obstacles surmountable, all ills curable. And you know what? I'm never alone, even when I'm alone, because you are my friend.
Mm-hmm.
Miss Amy Grant.
Da da da.
Patti and her guests will be right back.
I'll see you later.
Well, if you don't know me by now...
Now, it's about time you got here. Where have you been all night?
I was just checking out the scene before I committed myself. How do I look?
You look fine, but nobody's gonna see you anyway.
That's the story of our life. You go from rags to riches, and I go from rags to rags.
Rags? This sure don't look like no rag to me. It looks like it costs a pretty penny.
Yeah, my outfit costs a pretty penny, and yours costs an ugly couple of thou.
Oh, look, don't come off with me with that jealousy stuff. We've been together too long. You better change your attitude, little Miss Thing, and I mean it.
On stage, Patti.
That's my cue. I gotta go, and you better watch my fur coat. Don't steal it.
Jiminy Cricket didn't have to take such abuse.
Oh, I ain't Pinocchio either, sugar.
I wonder if I can still get a job with Tina Turner. What, Lord? I've got to do. Got to do with this.
Living life.
Yeah! I wanna keep you safe.
You can keep me safe.
Like a baby.
Like a baby.
To the early dawn. Walks up to the sun. It would be so nice if only for one night. If only for one night, we could spend forever in one night.
Oh,
if only for one night.
Oh, we could spend forever in one night.
If only for one night. That's all.
That's all.
That's all.
We'll be right back with Cyndi Lauper and Luther Vandross.
When I first met Patti, we talked a lot about color. See, and I didn't understand why she was talking to me about color, because you all know how I love muted tones. And she has a fascination with rainbows. So we started talking, and this piece came about. And this piece is called The Rainbow Road, and she asked me to paint it for her, and why not? Okay. This road begins with yellow. Good color. Pardon me one second. Okay. I'll get back to this here piece. All right. Yellow is for joy and happiness, sunshine and birth. And away we go.
Look to the rainbow and follow the fellow who follows the dream.
As you can tell by that loud mouth, that's me in the crib. Daddy knew there would never be a quiet moment after my arrival. But I would just go in my room and play make-believe with my animals because they were the only ones who would play with me.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the greatest dancer of them all?
This may come as a shock to you, but it sure ain't you, honey.
Now, I always knew I would be a singer or a dancer, but the mirror helped me make up my mind, and so did the choir at the Beulah Baptist Church.
Patti?
Sorry. Okay. This is for Blue Sky Promises.
Yeah? This is Big Al's used cars and new groups. No, no, it ain't fixed yet. Oh, we had to send to Germany for the parts. Hey, you ain't got to tell me it's a Chevy.
Al, here are the girls I was telling you about. They're from Elmwood.
Great, Patti. We'll call your group the Elm Tones.
Too loud.
Whew, I don't think. think you were too loud, honey. What's wrong with her?
Hi, Al. I got the other two girls for you, and they're both from Trenton.
Allie, fantastic. We'll call your group the Trenton.
Wait. It's the same as the first line. Could you speak to her, please?
Look, I just can't take this pressure.
So, the two remaining Trentones join the two remaining Elm Tones to form the Bluebells and make beautiful harmony, honey.
Hey, girls. Woo! Good to see you. Big Al ain't gonna like this. He's running out of cities, but we better sing anyway.
Next is green. Green is for innocence. Green is for the newness of spring and the longing for success.
Let's get her into country and western. It's definitely the coming thing.
Wrong. She's more the sophisticated type. Furs are the answer.
Are you serious?
Smashing. It's her.
It's not her. It's you.
Now, this is Patti.
Really, what am I supposed to be?
Sophisticated.
Whatever happened to South Philly?
It's gone into orbit.
And when we came down, honey, we really came down as LaBelle. Get down, girl.
Red is hot. And a ride on the red carpet ride.
Miss LaBelle, you're red hot right now. Does that give you a swelled head?
Well, not really. But if people don't like me, I can always open a restaurant because I'm a heck of a cook.
Oh, Miss LaBelle, is it true you plan to give a concert at the Metropolitan Opera House?
Well, if they can handle La Boheme and La Traviata, then I guess they're ready for LaBelle.
It's majestic. And for passion.
Look, look, look to the rainbow. Follow it over the hills and streams. Oh, look, look.
Daddy, you are right. If you sing long enough and loud enough, you'll find your golden dream at the end of the rainbow.
Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me. So
I just would like to say thank you for being a part of my life and letting me perform for you in the past. And my guests, they were totally awesome. What can I say? But I do want you to know one thing. You have not seen the last of me yet. I hope to see you real soon. Thank you. Good night, Mom and sisters. Bye.
Later, it's Laugh Out Loud Late Night Entertainment with the King of Comedy, Johnny Carson, on The Tonight Show starring Johnny Carson. Then on Late Night with David Letterman, David welcomes Diane Keaton. Let's all be there.
I'm Jane Pauley. Tomorrow morning on Today, a look at the best buys for Christmas. Also, Raymond Burr returns as Perry Mason and actress Mary Steenburgen. Join us tomorrow morning on Today.